हेलो नमस्कार, गुड मॉर्निंग एंड वेलकम टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 24/7। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड इन दिस सेशन आई विल ब्रिंग टू यू अनदर फाइव इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पीआईबी न्यूज। गाइस, टुडे सेशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज आज के पांच क्वेश्चंस में से मेरे हिसाब से आपके एग्जाम में दो या तीन क्वेश्चन जरूर आने वाले हैं। ऑलराइट, तो पे अटेंशन टू द सेशन एंड लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द क्वेश्चन नंबर वन। द यूनियन कैबिनेट हैज गिवन इट्स अप्रूवल टू री एस्टैब्लिश फार्माकोपिया कमीशन फॉर इंडियन मेडिसिन एंड होम्योपैथी एज अ सबॉर्डिनेट ऑफिस अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ आयुष हेडेड बाय श्रीपद येसो नायक। विच टू लेबोरेटरीज विल बी मर्ज्ड इनटू दिस PCIMNH। सो नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट दिस मर्जर। सो रिसेंटली यूनियन कैबिनेट हैज गिवन इट्स अप्रूवल टू री एस्टैब्लिश फार्माकोपिया कमीशन for Indian medicine and homeopathy as a subordinate office under the Ministry of Ayush, and there are two laboratories which will be merged under this. Number one is Pharmacopoeia Laboratory for Indian medicine and homeopathic Pharmacopoeia Laboratory. These central laboratories established at the Ghaziabad since 1975 will be merged into PCIMNH. Right. And now, what is the objective of this commission? What are the roles and responsibilities of this commission? So guys, this commission publicize and revise all the Ayurvedic, Siddha, Unani and Homeopathic Pharmacopoeia of India at suitable intervals and of such addenda or supplementary compendia during the intervening periods as may be deemed necessary. And now, what is the meaning of Pharmacopoeia? So guys, this is basically an official publication. Ye ek official publication hota hai which contains a list of medical drugs. Alright, which contains a list of medical drugs with their effects. Okay, so ये basically क्या है, एक official publication है जिसके अंदर एक list होती है medical drugs की और साथ में उसके effects की. So pharmacopoeia basically it is an official publication containing a list of medical drugs with their effects. Alright, so this is the objective, this is the role and responsibilities of this commission. And now this commission will be merged with Pharmacopoeia Laboratory for Indian Medicine and Homeopathic Pharmacopoeia Laboratory established at Ghaziabad. And now, what is the aim of this merger? So, it will enhance the standardization outcomes of Ayurveda, Siddha, Unani and Homeopathy drugs towards their effective regulation and quality control. इससे क्या होगा, जो उनका Ayurveda, Siddha, Unani और Homeopathy drugs का जो effective regulation है, वो अच्छा regulation effective होगा and जो quality control है, उसपे भी उसको भी एनहांसमेंट मिलेगा. राइट, एंड इट विल ऑल्सो हेल्प इन ऑप्टिमम यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज. नाउ व्हाट विल बी द पोस्ट मर्जर बेनिफिट्स? जब ये मर्जर हो जाएंगे तो इसके क्या क्या बेनिफिट्स होने वाले हैं? सो दिस मर्जर विल असाइन अ लीगल स्टेटस टू द मर्ज स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ PCIMNH एंड इट्स लेबोरेटरी बाय मेकिंग अमेंडमेंट्स इन द ड्रग एंड कॉस्मेटिक रूल्स ऑफ 1945, एंड PCIMNH विल हैव एडिक्वेट एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव स्ट्रक्चर अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ आयुष एंड इट विल बी एबल टू augment the capacity and outcomes of pharmacopoeial work. मतलब कि जो pharmacopoeia से related work है उसको capacity, उसकी capacity को augment कर सकेगा और उसके जो outcomes है उसको increase करा जा सकेगा. To achieve harmonization of pharmacopoeial standards of Ayurveda, Siddha, Unani and Homeopathy drugs. To prevent duplication and overlapping of drugs and standardization work. जो duplication है या फिर drug standardization काम का जो overlapping है उसको प्रिवेंट किया जा सकेगा, एंड इट विल ऑल्सो हेल्प इन ऑप्टिमल यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज इन एन इफेक्टिव मैनर. सो दीज आर सम पोस्ट मर्जर बेनिफिट्स. नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द क्वेश्चन. सो द क्वेश्चन वॉज विच टू लैबोरेटरीज विल बी मर्ज इनटू PCIMNH. सो द टू लैबोरेटरीज आर फार्माकोपोइया लैबोरेटरी फॉर इंडियन मेडिसिन एंड होम्योपैथिक फार्माकोपोइया लैबोरेटरी. सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर इज व्हाट गाइस? ऑप्शन सी 1 and 3. ऑप्शन सी 1 and 3 इज द करेक्ट आंसर. Now let's move on to next question. What is the name of the internship program jointly launched by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs and Ministry of HRD for fresh engineering graduates to provide an opportunity to work for urban local bodies and smart cities in the countries? हमें internship program का नाम बताना है जिसको launch किया गया है jointly by the Ministry of HRD and Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs फॉर फ्रेश इंजीनियरिंग ग्रेजुएट्स, ताकि उनको अपॉर्चुनिटी प्रोवाइड कराई जा सके फॉर अर्बन लोकल बॉडीज एंड स्मार्ट सिटीज के लिए काम करने के लिए. सो नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट दिस फर्स्ट. सो द नेम ऑफ द इंटर्नशिप प्रोग्राम गाइज इज ट्यूलिप प्रोग्राम. ऑलराइट, द नेम ऑफ द प्रोग्राम इज व्हाट? ट्यूलिप. एंड दिस हैज बीन स्टार्टेड टू प्रोवाइड इंटर्नशिप अपॉर्चुनिटीज टू थाउजेंड्स ऑफ फ्रेश इंजीनियरिंग ग्रेजुएट्स इन द अर्बन सेक्टर अंडर द स्मार्ट सिटीज प्रोजेक्ट. ऑलराइट, एंड द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ दिस प्रोग्राम will be minimum of 8 weeks up to 1 year. And who are eligible under this program? So those students who have a degree of B.Tech, B.Planning, B.Arch, B.A., B.Sc., B.Com, LLB can register for internships as per their interest. And there will be a certificate which will be digitally signed and shareable by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, State Government, AICTE and the urban local bodies or the respective Smart City Act. डिजिटली साइंड और एक शेयरेबल सर्टिफिकेट भी प्रोवाइड कराया जाएगा जो कि इश्यू किया जाएगा बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स स्टेट गवर्नमेंट AICTE एंड द अर्बन लोकल बॉडी. नाउ व्हाट विल बी द एक्सपेक्टेड बेनिफिट्स ऑफ दिस प्रोग्राम. सो इट वुड हेल्प एनहांसिंग द वैल्यू टू मार्केट ऑफ इंडियन ग्रेजुएट्स एंड क्रिएटिंग अ पोटेंशियल टैलेंट पूल इन डाइवर्स फील्ड्स लाइक अर्बन प्लानिंग, ट्रांसपोर्ट इंजीनियरिंग, एनवायरमेंट, म्यूनिसिपल फाइनेंस एटसेट्रा. सो बेसिकली ये क्या करेगा, जो इंडियन ग्रेजुएट्स की मार्केट वैल्यू है उसको इंक्रीज करेगा और एक पूल बनाएगा पोटेंशियल टैलेंट्स का और उसको यूज करेगा इन अलग अलग फील्ड्स लाइक अर्बन प्लानिंग, ट्रांसपोर्ट इंजीनियरिंग एंड एक्सेट्रा. एंड इट विल प्रोवाइड इंटर्न्स विद हैंड्स ऑन लर्निंग एक्सपीरियंस. जो इंटर्न्स होंगे उनको पूरा का पूरा लर्निंग एक्सपीरियंस प्रोवाइड कराया जाएगा. एंड फॉर यूएलबीज एंड स्मार्ट सिटीज हाउ इट विल बेनिफिट. सो इट विल बेनिफिट देम बाय इन्फ्यूजिंग ऑफ fresh ideas and energy with engagement of youth and it will also help in solving India's urban challenges. Alright. And this launch will also play an important stepping stone for fulfillment of MHRD and AICTE's goal of 1 crore successful internship by the year 2025. इस लॉन्च के बाद जो MHRD और AICTE का गोल है कि 1 crore successful internship provide करानी है by the year 2025, उस गोल को भी पूरा किया जा सकेगा. Alright. And now this portal has been developed by the AICTE and it will provide immense flexibility to all the urban local bodies or smart cities and interns to enable convenient access. And the technical support for the platform shall be anchored by the AICTE and the programmatic non-technical support shall be anchored by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. And for this an MOU has also been signed between MOHUA and AICTE, which lays down roles and responsibilities of AICTE and MOHUA respectively over a period of 5 years. एक MOU भी साइन किया गया है between the Ministry of Housing and AICTE ताकि दोनों के roles and responsibilities को properly define किया जा सके for the period of 5 years. Alright, so now what was the question? So guys, the question is, we have to tell the name of the internship program. So it is very clear now that the name of the internship program is TULIP. TULIP Urban Learning Internship Program is the correct answer. So option D is the correct answer. Now let's move on to the question number 3. Now next question is, the Union Cabinet has given its approval for setting up of an empowered group of secretaries in ministries or departments of Government of India for attracting investments in India. Which of the following is not the expected benefit of this step? So now let us first discuss about this. So recently Union Cabinet has given its approval for setting up of an empowered group of secretaries and project development cells in ministries or departments of Government of India for attracting investments in India. And the objective behind this is that it will reinforce India's vision of becoming a $5 trillion economy by the financial year 2025. And also this will give a boost to the economy and open up immense direct and indirect employment potential in various sectors, जैसा कि requirement है अभी हमारे देश में. यानी कि हमारी economy को boost करेगा और बहुत सारे direct और indirect employment potential generate करेगा in the various sectors as required by the current scenario, current condition of the economy of our country. And to put in place an investment friendly ecosystem that strongly supports the domestic investor as well as FDI, this step has been taken. So basically, इसमें एक investment friendly ecosystem बनाया जाएगा जो कि strongly support करेगा domestic investors को भी और साथ साथ foreign direct investors को भी. Okay, and now, what will be the composition of empowered group of secretaries? So guys, the chairperson of this group will be the Cabinet Secretary of India, who is Mr. Rajiv Gaba. Mr. Rajiv Gaba is the Cabinet Secretary of India. CEO of Niti Aayog, who is Mr. Amitabh Kant. Secretary of DPIIT, yani ki Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, he is Guru Prasad Mohapatra. Other than this, Secretary Department of Commerce ke Secretary hai Dr. Anoop Vadhwan. सेक्रेटरी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ रेवेन्यू हु इज मिस्टर अजय भूषण पांडे, सेक्रेटरी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इकोनॉमिक अफेयर्स हु इज मिस्टर तरुण बजाज एंड द सेक्रेटरी ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट कंसर्न. सो दिस विल बी द कॉम्पोजिशन ऑफ एम्पावर्ड ग्रुप ऑफ सेक्रेटरीज. एंड नाउ व्हाट इज दिस प्रोजेक्ट डेवलपमेंट सेल? सो दिस इज ऑल्सो अप्रूव्ड फॉर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ इन्वेस्टेबल प्रोजेक्ट्स इन कोऑर्डिनेशन बिटवीन द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एंड द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स. Its objective is to grow the pipeline of investable projects in India and in turn increasing FDI inflows. And it will also help to create projects with all approvals, land available for allocation and with the complete detailed project reports for adoption or investment by investors. So these are the objectives of this project development cell. And under the guidance of secretary and officer not below the rank of joint secretary of each relevant सेंट्रल मिनिस्ट्री विल बी द इंचार्ज ऑफ द पीडीसी, यानी कि प्रोजेक्ट डेवलपमेंट सेल. बेसिकली एक ऑफिसर जो कि ज्वाइंट सेक्रेटरी से नीचे की रैंक का नहीं होना चाहिए ऑफ द ईच रेलेवेंट मिनिस्ट्री, वो इस पीडीसी का इंचार्ज होगा. एंड द इंचार्ज ऑफ द पीडीसी विल बी टास्क्ड टू कंसेप्चुलाइज, इंप्लीमेंट एंड डिसेमिनेट डिटेल्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू इन्वेस्टेबल प्रोजेक्ट. बेसिकली सारे जो भी प्रोजेक्ट्स होंगे इन्वेस्टेबल प्रोजेक्ट्स, उनको कंसेप्चुलाइज करना, इंप्लीमेंट करना और डिसेमिनेट करने का काम जो होगा वो होगा in charge of the PDC ka. So now let's move on to the question. What was the question? So which of the following is not the expected benefits of this step? It will put in place an investment friendly ecosystem. Yes, this is absolutely correct. It will support only global investors. No guys, this is also for the domestic investors. So it will support both domestic investors and the FDI. So therefore the correct answer will be what? Option B will be the correct answer. Now let's move on to question number 4. Prime Minister Narendra Modi pledged $15 million as India's contribution to the Alliance Gavi at the Global Virtual Summit that was hosted by the UK and participated by over 50 countries. Now, what is this Gavi? Okay, so now let us discuss about this. So, India pledges $15 million to the Global Vaccines Alliance, jiska naam hai Gavi, and the full form of Gavi is Global Alliance for Vaccines and Immunization. Alright, and this was hosted by the UK. And it was participated by over 50 countries. Now let us discuss about the Gavi. So it is the Global Alliance for Vaccines and Immunization. And it is a public-private global health partnership with the goal of increasing access to immunization in poor countries. Jitne bhi poor countries hai, wahan pe immunization ka access increase karna iska goal hai. And it brings together developing countries and donor governments and other organizations like WHO, UNICEF, World Bank. In both industrialized and developing countries and many more. And Gavi has observer status at the World Health Assembly. World Health Assembly mein Gavi ka ek observer status bhi hai. Alright. So basically is alliance ka jo basic aim hai, basic goal hai, wo immunization ka access provide karana hai in the poor countries. So now let's move on to the question. So humse pucha gaya that what is this Gavi? So Gavi guys, it is a global vaccines alliance. So option A, a global vaccines alliance will be the correct answer. Now let's move on to the question number 5, which is a very easy question. Aap sabko aata hoga. The Union Cabinet has given its approval to rename Kolkata Port as what? So guys, recently, kuch samay pehle Kolkata Port ke 150th anniversary pe iske announcement ki gayi thi that the Kolkata Port will be renamed as Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Port. Alright, Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Port, and iska approval de diya gaya hai by the Union Cabinet. Alright, and now the Kolkata port, it is the oldest operating port in India. Okay, this is very important. It is the oldest operating port in India and it was constructed by the British East India Company. And also it is the only riverine major port. Alright, ye keval akela riverine major port hai India mein, and there are 12 major ports in India. Alright, there are 12 major ports in India. Now, can you tell me the difference between major ports and minor ports? So now, major ports, let me explain you this. So guys, major ports are those that are administered by Union Shipping Ministry. Alright, that are administered by Union Shipping Ministry through the Major Port Trust Act of 1963. So these are the major ports. And minor ports are those which are regulated or administered by the state legislations. Alright, so this is the basic difference between the major port and minor port. And there are various other differences like जो मेजर पोर्ट्स होते हैं वहां से केवल इंटरनेशनल कार्गो मूव करता है, लेकिन माइनर पोर्ट्स में नेशनल कार्गो भी मूव कर सकते हैं. राइट, सो दिस इज द बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन मेजर पोर्ट एंड माइनर पोर्ट. ओके, एंड द कोलकाता पोर्ट is the guiding factor to trade and commerce of vast hinterland comprising the entire eastern India, including Bihar and eastern Uttar Pradesh, and two landlocked Himalayan kingdoms of Nepal and Bhutan. And this port trust, it is an autonomous body under the Ministry of Shipping, administered through the Major Port Trust Act of 1963. All right. So therefore, guys, the correct answer it was E. Shama Prasad Mukherjee Port. Okay, so that's it for the session today. I hope you like it. For more updates, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.